Hi dear children, welcome back to 9th standard history online class. In our previous history class we have learned that the period between 13th to 15th century the North India was ruled by Delhi Sultans. After conquering a large part of North India, these sultans entrusted their commanders the responsibility to conquer South India. The credit for successful invasion of South India goes to Alauddin Khilji's commander Malik Kafur. The South Indian dynasties like Yadavas of Devagiri, Kakatiyas of Warangal, the Pandyas of Madurai, Hoysalas of Dwarasamudra, the Cholas of Tanjavur, all became the victims of a violent attack of Alauddin Khilji. As a result of the attack of Malik Kafur and Alauddin Khilji, political instability, lawlessness, fear and religious turmoil prevailed everywhere. Under these circumstances, the kingdom of Vijayanagara was born. The establishment of Vijayanagara Empire enabled the protection of the Hindu religion and Indian culture. Hakka and Bukka established Vijayanagara Empire on the bank of Tungabhadra River in the year 1336. Later, Hampi became the capital of Vijayanagara Empire. There are four dynasties which ruled over Vijayanagara Empire. They are Sangama dynasty, Salava dynasty, Tuluva dynasty and Aravidu dynasty. Harihara first, Bukkaraya, Harihara second and Proudadevaraya were the famous kings of the Sangama dynasty. Harihara laid the foundation for the Vijayanagara Empire. Now, let us learn about the important rulers of this dynasty. Bukkaraya. The early life of Bukkaraya as well as his brother Harihara are relatively unknown. Most accounts of their early life are based on various theories. One of the theory states that Bukka and Hakka were commanders of the army of Kakatiya king of Warangal. After the king of Warangal was defeated by Muhammad bin Tughlaq, Bukka and his brother were taken prisoners and sent to Delhi. Both were forced to convert Islam religion. Bukka and his brother eventually escaped and reconverted to Hinduism under the influence of sage Vidyaranya and founded Vijayanagara Empire. Bukkaraya was successful in solving the religious war between the Jains and Sri Vaishnavas, thereby upheld religious harmony in his kingdom. Bukkaraya defeated the Reddys of Kondavidu and merged Pennukonda area with his empire. He constructed a fort and a few temples in the capital and encouraged agricultural activities. Bukhraya sent an ambassador to the court of a Chinese king belonging to the Ming dynasty. Bukhra's son, Kambana, defeated the Sultan of Madurai and enlarged his kingdom. This victory is marked in Madura Vijayam written by Ganga Devi. Harihara II became the ruler of Vijayanagara Empire when Bukhraya I died in 1377 and ruled till his death in 1404. He was the son of Bukhraya. During his rule, the Vijayanagara Empire comprised of a vast area. During his reign, he continued to extend the kingdom's territory through fighting against the Reddys of Kondavidu for control of the Andhra between Nellore and Kalinga. Harihara took his control Kondavidu, Karnool and Nellore forts. At the time of the death of Bahamani Sultan Mujahid, Harihara expanded his kingdom from Goa to north of the Konkan coast. He conquered the fort of Pangala, lying to the north of Krishna River in the year 1398. Devaraya II, also known as Prouda Devaraya, was the most famous king in the Sangama dynasty. According to the historian Shastri, Devaraya II had the title Gajabetagara, which means elephant hunter. It is a metaphor referring to his victories against enemies who were as strong as elephants. Devaraya II defeated the king Gajapati Kapilendra of Orissa and seized Kondavidu. By suppressing the regional leaders of the border, he expanded the kingdom up to Krishna River in the northeast. Later, Devaraya II defeated the Kerala ruler and received royalties from Kerala and Sri Lanka. This earned him the title Dakshina Padada Chakravarti, which means the Emperor of the South. Devaraya II chased the traditional foe Ahmad Shah of Bahamani till Bijapur and occupied Mudagal and Bangapura. His commander Lakkana Dandisha took up a successful naval voyage. Devaraya II was tolerant towards other religions. He constructed a mosque, Jain and Vaishnava temple in the capital. Being a poet himself, he had in his court the Sanskrit scholar Dindima and Kannada scholar Lakkana Dandisha. During his period, Veerashaiva tradition and literature saw a revival. After the death of Devaraya II in 1446, his kingdom became weak and weak kings came to power and the rule of the Sangama dynasty came to an end. Krishna Devaraya was the most famous king among the rulers of Vijayanagara Empire. During his rule, the Vijayanagara Empire reached the pinnacle of glory. Comparable to world famous rulers like Ashoka, Samudragupta and Harshavardhana, Krishnadevaraya ruled over 20 years. He possessed the largest empire in India after the decline of the Delhi Sultanate. Krishnadevaraya earned the titles the Lord of Kannada Empire and Andhra Bhoja. Portuguese travelers Domingo Paes and Fernão Nunes visited his empire. When Krishnadevaraya came to power, the kingdom was facing various complicated internal and external problems. The Europeans who had arrived through new sea route were establishing colonies. The Mughals of the north were trying to expand their empire in the south. The five Shahi kingdoms of the Bahmani dynasty became powerful sultanate and plunged into war against Krishnadevaraya. In addition to these problems, the kings of Ummattur and Orissa were a constant source of threat. The military achievements of Krishnadevaraya. According to Robert Sewall, Krishnadevaraya was an unparalleled warrior, shrewd commander, and political expert. He won all the wars and expanded his empire in the south. When the time of Krishnadevaraya ascended the throne, the law and order situation of Vijayanagara Empire had worsened due to internal rivalries. He undertook 14 major wars. These wars were waged against Bahmani, Adil Shahi of Bijapur, Nizam Shahi of Ahmednagar, Qutub Shahi of Golconda, Gajapati of Orissa, and other chieftains. Krishnadevaraya liberated Muhammad Shah and made him the king of Bahmani kingdom. Hence, he got the title Yavanaraja Pratishthapanacharya. After destroying the power of Bahmani, he added Ummattur towards his kingdom. Among the wars waged by Krishnadevaraya, the war with Gajapati of Orissa is important. This war took place from 1512 to 1518. The end of the battle, Gajapati surrendered and got his daughter married to Krishnadevaraya. In 1520, he captured Raichur from Adil Shahi of Bijapur. Krishnadevaraya helped the Portuguese to capture Goa. During his regime, the Vijayanagara kingdom extended from river Godavari and Krishna in the north to the Indian Ocean in the south, from Arabian Sea in the west to Bay of Bengal in the east. Krishnadevaraya was not only a skilled warrior but also an able administrator. His Telugu work Amukta Malida reveals the shrewdness he possessed in the matters of state. He provided irrigation facilities for the expansion of agriculture. With the friendship of the Portuguese, he increased the foreign trade. He was a great patron of art, literature and religions. There were 8 Telugu poets known as Ashtadigajas in his court. Krishnadevaraya was a poet himself and wrote the play Jambavati Kalyana in Sanskrit. Krishnadevaraya constructed a Krishna temple at Hampi. Along with many of the temples, he erected a Maharanga Mandapa in Virupaksha temple at Hampi and also many other temples. Fall of Vijayanagara Empire. After Krishnadevaraya, Achyutaraya and Sadashivaraya came to the throne. Krishnadevaraya's son-in-law Ramaraya handled the administration in able manner. Although Ramaraya had improved the prestige of the kingdom by waging many wars during his 23 years, many foes had sprung up against Vijayanagara Empire. Counteracting to the frequent attacks by the Deccan Shahi Sultans, Ramaraya had occupied Vijayapura and Golconda forts. This had provoked the Sultans to wage war against Ramaraya. The Deccan Sultans, who were envious of the progress and prosperity of the Vijayanagara Empire, forgot their political differences and united in the name of their religion. In 1565, the united army of the four kingdoms mounted an attack on Vijayanagar. Ramaraya's army was defeated in this battle and he died. The victorious army of the Deccan Sultans plundered the glorious kingdom of Vijayanagar. As a result, the capital Hampi became a ruin.